So iOS 18 is finally landing on your iPhone, so whether you're in the process of updating or you're waiting for the update to happen, or you're wondering if you should update, there's plenty of features here worth getting to know. I'm Cam Bunton from Trusted Reviews, and in this video I'm going to show you the things that you need to try first. So first up, color theme your app icons. So Apple is finally letting us customize our home screens properly in iOS 18. One of the ways you can do that is to use the same color and shade across all of your app icons and widgets. To do it, just press and hold on the home screen or any app icon and you'll see an edit icon in the top left corner. Tap that and then tap Customise in the drop-down menu. Now you'll see a little tab slide up from the bottom of the display. You can change the theme so that it's dark or light, but keeping the original colors, or if you choose tinted, you can choose any color you want from a whole spectrum using the color and saturation sliders at the bottom. If you tap the little sun button on the left corner, it'll change your background wallpaper from light to dark or back again. And if you tap the little ink dropper icon, you can choose a specific color from your wallpaper and use that as your color shade so that it matches your wallpaper precisely. Number two, try the new torch. The new torch feature in iOS 18 is pretty clever. So if you switch on your torch or flashlight from your lock screen, you'll see a custom torch control appear around the dynamic island at the top of the screen. You can slide vertically up and down to increase and decrease the brightness, but if you swipe horizontally left or right, you can increase the spread of the light so it covers a wider or narrower area. Remove the torch shortcut. In iOS 18, you can remove the torch shortcut from your lock screen and replace it with any other shortcut that you want. To do so, tap and hold your lock screen and tap the Customize option at the bottom. Now choose the lock screen from the two thumbnail views and then you'll see a minus near the torch shortcut. Tap that to remove it, and if you want to put something else there instead, tap the plus that's appeared in the place where it was. Now choose any shortcut that you like to put there instead. Set your charge limit. There's a new set of charging optimizations in iOS 18 that let you customize and set the charging limit. The idea being that if you're not charging to 100% every single time, it helps the battery last for longer. In older versions of the software, it would only let you set the limit to 80%, but now lets you do it in 5% increments. So go to Settings, Battery, and then tap Charging. On the next screen, you can set it to any limit at 5% increments between 80 and 100%. What's more, iOS 18 will learn your behaviors and give you the recommendation based on how you use your phone. But select the limit that you want, and now when you plug it in to charge, it will only charge to that amount and won't go all the way to 100%. Use the action button to recognize music. Now you can use the action button on the side of the iPhone as a quick Shazam button. In older software, you had to do this via a shortcuts app on the iPhone, but now there's a direct option to use it for Shazam. So head to Settings, Action button, and on the next screen, swipe across until you find the Recognize Music option. Now when you press the Action button, it'll automatically recognize the song playing in your area. Hide any apps. So in iOS 18, you can hide any apps you want in its own little hidden folder that lives in the app library screen. To hide an app, just long press on the app icon and you'll see a couple of options appear. Tap the Require Face ID option. Your next pop-up option asks if you want to lock it behind a scan or hide it and lock it. Choose the hiding option and it'll vanish and make its way to your new folder of hidden apps in your library. You can access it at any time by swiping across to your app library and then scrolling down until you find the hidden apps folder. Every time you want to go in there, it'll ask for a Face ID scan. Create a widget from an app icon. So in iOS 18, you can now create widgets from apps without leaving the home screen. You can just tap and hold on any icon, and if it has widgets available, you'll see those little squares and rectangles in the drop-down menu. Tap the one that you want and it'll create a widget in the shape of the icon that you choose, whether it's a small square, a large square, or a full-width rectangle. Schedule messages. So in iOS 18, you can finally schedule a message for a set time. So if you work with or are in contact with someone in a different time zone, or just want to send a message for the next day in advance before you forget, whatever the reason, you can schedule it for the appropriate time. Just open your messages and start typing the message. And when you're ready to schedule, tap the plus icon on the left, and in the list of options, you'll see Send Later. Pick the time and date that you want to schedule it for, and then line it up. Power off from Control Center. You can now switch off your phone without pressing any physical buttons. Just swipe your Control Center down from the top of the screen and you'll see a little power icon in the top right corner. Tap that button and then hold it until you feel the haptic vibration and then let go and you'll get the regular power menu appearing. Swipe to power off. Simple. Share your Wi-Fi network with a QR code. Now, there's more than one way to share your Wi-Fi network details in iOS, but one of them lets you generate a QR code for easy sharing with others. Open the new Passwords app, unlock it with a Face ID scan, and then choose the Wi-Fi option and you'll see any saved Wi-Fi networks listed, with your current connection at the top. Tap it, and then on the next screen, tap Show Network QR Code, scan it from the other phone, and it should connect you. Transcribe your voice memos. So Voice Memos has the ability to transcribe your voice recordings, turning them into text on the screen. So just open the app and find the recording that you want to transcribe. Tap it and then tap the three dots next to that recording and choose Edit Recording. And then tap the little speech bubble icon in the bottom left and it'll transcribe that recording for you. Any new recording should transcribe automatically as you record. So when you've saved a new one, you can tap the three dot icon again and there's a View Transcript option in that menu for you to read the text. Reorganize and customize Control Center. The new Control Center lets you customize grids, icons, and even create multiple sheets and pages of controls. To do so, just swipe down the Control Center as usual from the top. Now tap the plus icon in the top left corner. You can remove any existing controls by tapping the minus icon next to any of them, or if you want to resize, just drag that curved tap on the right side. Add new controls by tapping Add Control at the bottom of the screen and then choosing the control that you want to place it on the screen. To create new control sheets, just swipe upwards until you get to a blank page and tap the Add Control button at the bottom. Using the Resize tool, you can even make full screen controls like the music and media playback control. It's really flexible, so play around with it until it works for you. So sadly, since Apple Intelligence isn't coming in this version of iOS 18, there's nothing really for you to try on that front here. You'll have to wait until around about December time until iOS 18.1 lands, at which point it's probably going to need its own separate video. So stay tuned for that. Obviously subscribe, hit that like button if you did like this video, of course. But now let's get on to some classic tips. So these have been in place in the iOS software for some time, but I always find them really useful almost every day that I'm using my phone. First of them is the trackpad keyboard. The keyboard trackpad feature is the absolute easiest way to move the cursor on screen to exactly where you want it to be, and saves you having to tap on the text itself. So while typing, just tap and hold the spacebar, the letter keys sort of vanish, and it becomes a trackpad. Just swipe your thumb or finger around and move the cursor precisely where you want it to go. Backtap to screenshot. So Backtap to screenshot is another I've used regularly for a couple of years now. Just simply tapping twice on the back of the phone near the Apple logo can launch any number of functions and apps. Head to Settings, Accessibility, then Touch, and at the bottom you'll find Backtap. Tap it, and then on the next screen choose the double tap option, and then select Screenshot from the list of options. And lastly, move multiple apps into folders at once. You can add multiple apps into a folder together really quickly and easily using a pretty old trick. You just tap and hold an app icon and start moving it, and as it's moving, just tap all the other apps on the screen that you want to group with it, and let go when it's on top of another icon that you want to create a folder with. So there are, of course, loads of other things that you can try in iOS 18 if you're happy to go digging. Let me know your favourites that I've mentioned in this video or that I haven't mentioned and that I've missed. Use the comments down below or you can get me on social media. I'm at Cam Bunton on Threads, for example. If you did like this video, please do leave a thumbs up, subscribe and tap that notification bell. And I'll see you again in the next one. Thanks so much for watching. Bye bye.